Hello YouTube, it's Sunday evening, April 10th, and as you look here, we have new data. I guess I missed this, I was doing something else. Came out on April 8th, and the close approach is pretty close to the last one. It's still showing about 0.234, rounded off, at about 1951. I think it was 1955 last time or something like that. You have to look at the old video. The biggest difference is right here. Okay, they've increased the comet total magnitude to 10.6. If you remember, it was 12.0 in the last report. And they've also added a few more items here. The biggest one is right here, comet nuclear magnitude. They're putting the M2 at 13.2. Now, if you remember last time, they didn't have a magnitude for the nucleus. They just had the total. So now they're giving us a 13.2 magnitude on the nucleus. And if you want to go that way with it, you can go over to the Minor Planet Center and you can look up what 13.2 is. And it's down here, and you're looking at around somewhere between 4 and 5 kilometers. I guess, I don't know, 4.7, something like that. So that's pretty close to 5. I was using 5 for a while. I went up to 7 when I decided, what the heck, I got to put something down, so I just put down what the total magnitude was, and that was 7 back then. Now it's they're giving us a 13.2 on the nucleus, so that's going to give me a 4.7 on the nucleus size. And if you look at the program here, you'll see that I've got it at 5, put it back to 5 from 7. I've increased the absolute magnitude 10.6. Now that makes a big difference on your tail diameter, your tail length and diameter. But you can be able to see this later on in the program. There's a big difference in the tail from what it was. And go back to the browser for a minute. There was another thing that came out recently, and that was dates of observable comets. We go to here and look down to our comet here, and they've gone the other way. The last time I saw it, it was 16.6. Now they're putting it at 16.9, and this was from April 9th, pretty close to April 10th. But they're putting the apparent magnitude down at 16.9 now instead of 16.6. And then our Discoverer came up with an article, came out today. And he's got a picture here, and I think what they're doing is they're measuring the tail in here with the coma. He goes through and explains it here, and talks about the diameter being 1 minute of arc, or 80,000 kilometers. And if you look at his picture that he's got here, he's got a big red blob here in the center, and then he's got the 1 arc minute here. And pay close attention to this part of it here, where he talks about it's possible that such a rapid growth of the coma is associated with the apparent superposition over it of the comet's dust tail, which after opposition still remains invisible to earthly viewer. Now that's what I think's going on, because if you calculate the tail diameter right now, or tail length right now from Earth, it's right at 1 arc minute, maybe a little bit more than 1 arc minute. And so that would agree with his 1 arc minute here and saying it's 80,000. So he's even stating it right here, that it's possible that he's measuring the tail along with the coma. And the picture shows a big red blob in the center. I'm saying that's probably the coma there. And what he's measuring out here is probably the tail. But it's just not that much of a difference. But the even NASA gives you a bigger magnitude, or lower magnitude, whatever, for the total magnitude, which indicates that the coma is growing in brightness. It goes from a 12 to a 10.6. That's showing a brighter coma. All right, so I guess that's about all we have from here. And as you can go back to the program here, and we'll take and look in on the coma and tail right now. Here's what you're seeing right now from that position in space. And just want to do something else than what I want. You look at it right here, it's only showing, showing 3 minutes, almost 4 minutes from this position. This position is 2.1 astronomical units from the sun. If you look at the close approach data I've got here, this is for 10:16 local time, which is 19:51 NASA time, universal time. You're getting a close approach tail length now of about 4 degrees. So you see it's grown quite a bit with that change. I think before we were getting about 1 degree, now it's showing 4 degrees. And if we go to the 26th date, this is September 26th, this is when it's going to be in between us and the sun. And you can actually see a little bit of a tail there now. Before you couldn't hardly see a tail until you zoomed in. And we're showing the distance still about 0.383 in between the sun and the earth on September 26th. And if you take and you zoom in now, you'll see a little bit more of a tail than the last time. I think last time we were showing, I can't remember what we were showing, but right now we're showing about maybe 21 minutes from this location. Again, we're located up here. And you zoom back out. You can see here's the Earth and here's the tail, and of course, as the last time, the comet's orbit is up above the Earth's orbit. So even if the tail was longer, it's going to be up above us. You can see this is the Earth's orbit, the green one here, and it goes back over here. So it's almost a flat orbit. And we go on over to the close approach flat. Here we have it again. This is for October 16th, 1951, which is what NASA's giving for their close approach down here. 1951 16th, and it's showing 0.2338, which is going to be 0.234. And we're getting the same thing we got last time, 0.234. But as you noticed last time, you couldn't see a tail, and you're able to see a tail through here now. But of course, like last time, it's up above the Earth's orbit. So even if it was a much longer tail, it's going to be up above the Earth. And we can take and zoom in and see what it looks like. Now there's nothing that says that as it gets closer to the sun, they're going to increase the magnitude even higher, or lower, whatever you want to call it. But anyway, you're probably going to see it increase again as it gets closer to the sun, and so that's going to make the tail lengths even longer. Right here on the 16th at close approach, you're going to have a tail length of about 2.5 degrees as of the settings right now. All you have to do to change is change the settings. As soon as you get new data out, well, you change the settings. One of the things some of the people are talking about is how the discoverer called it a not a normal comet. Now, what he's talking about there, if you look at the orbits here, you'll see that most of the orbits are closed. You got mostly closed orbits here. Now, we're pretty close in right now. We'll take and zoom out. And if you zoom out, you can see a lot of these orbits, they close. Now, here's our comet, Elenin's orbit. And if you notice, it doesn't close. And if you look around the data, you'll find that they don't have a period for it yet. Now you see this is a pretty long one here, and they've got it closed and they've got a period on it. But you can even zoom out way out to this one down here, and it is really big orbit. They've got a period on it. But our new one, they don't have an orbit on it yet, don't have a period on it yet. So that makes it not a normal comet. A normal comet, you would have a period on it. You can see it right here. It just stretches off and disappears. There's a few other ones that do that. But most of them do have a period and a closed orbit. But this one being new, which also makes it It's a long period comet that makes it unusual. So anyway, I thought I would just show you that. It's not much has changed. The biggest thing that has changed is they've got a nucleus size on it. Before, they didn't have a nucleus size. So we'll take and center this again and give you what it looks like. It's going to look basically the same as all the other movies here. I'll take and speed it up. So the biggest thing that has changed right now is, like I say, they've given us the nucleus size. And if you look right here, you'll see that the comet's getting close to Stereo B. That means that we're probably going to be able to get some pictures of it at this time. Now, best I can figure, I don't know when they're going to start training the cameras on it, but if you look at the date right here, it's getting close. Right here is showing just under a half astronomical unit, and that's July. And as it goes on through, you'll see that they're very close together right in here. If you can read that, it says, I think, 0.117. So we're going to get some good pictures of Stereo B, taking pictures of the comet here. Probably around the 1st of August. Be looking out for that. Otherwise, not much to look out for until then. Still got our asteroid over here. Nothing's changed on it. Alright, well, I guess that's about all I have to say. You can so look at the close approach data here and see that it's going to be quite a ways up above us. No, it's the wrong one. Keep getting the stars. 0.234. And this is this view right here. You're actually inside the asteroid. It's going to be coming close November 8th. That's why the orbit looks like it's really changing. You're viewing it from the asteroid. You can see it's fading away in the distance here, and the Earth's getting closer. There it goes. So I could say you're, from this view right here, you're sitting inside the asteroid, and you're going to get a nice close view of the Earth here pretty soon. In fact, let's take and here we go. That's what it would look like if you're sitting on the asteroid as it zooms by. It's kind of close. 207 kilometers. And there goes the moon. All right, well, that's all I have for this video, so we'll talk to you later.